Hello, this is Frank Gaylard from radiopedia.org, and today we're going to talk about hypertensive hemorrhages. Intracranial hemorrhages have traditionally been divided into primary and secondary, with primary hemorrhages being further subdivided into those due to chronic, poorly controlled hypertension and lobar hemorrhages. Secondary hemorrhages typically are those that arise from an underlying tumour, a vascular malformation, or hemorrhagic transformation of a previous ischemic infarct, or of a venous infarct. In reality, both hypertensive and lobar hemorrhages do have underlying pathology, making the distinction between primary and secondary hemorrhages somewhat academic. Intracranial hemorrhages can also be divided according to location. Generally, these are thought of as lobar hemorrhages located within the cerebral lobes superficially, basal ganglia hemorrhages arising from the grey matter of the basal ganglia and thalamus, pontine hemorrhages, and cerebellar hemisphere hemorrhages. It is the latter three that we will be discussing today, as all three are associated with chronic, poorly controlled hypertension. Approximately 80% of hypertensive hemorrhages arise from the basal ganglia and thalami, with a further 10% from the pons, and the remaining 10% from the cerebellar hemispheres. This distribution correlates with the distribution of the underlying pathology, which is thought to be so-called Charcot-Bouchard aneurysms or microaneurysms. These are small aneurysms, typically between 0.3 and 0.9 millimeters in size, arising from small perforating vessels whose diameter is 0.1 to 0.3 millimeters. They are somewhat controversial and are not usually identified on imaging. The distribution of Charcot-Bouchard aneurysms matches those of hypertensive hemorrhages, with most being found in the lenticulostriate vessels of the basal ganglia. These aneurysms arise as a result of chronic changes within the walls of these perforating vessels, and these vessels can go on to either thrombose, in which case you develop a lacunar infarct, they can leak, resulting in microhemorrhages, or they can rupture, resulting in a true hemorrhage. The distribution of microhemorrhages acting as a surrogate for Charcot-Bouchard aneurysms is seen on MRI with T2 star weighted imaging or susceptibility weighted imaging, as small regions of signal dropout, typically seen in and around the basal ganglia in chronic uncontrolled hypertension. These should be distinguished from the microhemorrhages seen in cerebral amyloid angiopathy, which underlies in most cases of primary lobar hemorrhage, where they are located peripherally within the brain. As a differential on the MRI appearance is that of multiple cavernous malformations seen either as an autosomal dominant inherited condition or as a result of prior cranial irradiation. The location of hypertensive hemorrhages deep within the brain and usually adjacent to the ventricles makes them prone to extend into the ventricular system. On the first image, we can see a left-sided basal ganglia hemorrhage extending into the left lateral ventricle. On the second image, a pontine hemorrhage extends posteriorly into the fourth ventricle and extends superiorly through the aqueduct of Sylvius and into the third ventricle. When such extension occurs, it is not surprising that obstructive non-communicating hydrocephalus develops, as is seen in this case, with marked prominence of the temporal horns and some early transependymal edema. The overlying sulci are also effaced. The differential for a hypertensive hemorrhage includes an underlying tumour, an underlying vascular malformation, either a small arteriovenous malformation or a cavernous malformation, and specifically in the case of basal ganglia hemorrhages, that of underlying Moyamoya disease, where the abnormal enlarged perforator vessels are prone to hemorrhage. This is typically the case in adults rather than in children, who tend to present with ischemic symptoms. And finally, with venous infarcts, which typically also hemorrhage. In this location, deep vein thrombosis of the internal cerebral veins or vein of Galen or basal veins of Rosenthal should be suspected. You can read more about basal ganglia and hypertensive hemorrhages on radiopedia.org. In our next video, we will be covering lobar hemorrhages. See you then.